गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रन चिल्ड्रन आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 14 दैट इज बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री एंड चिल्ड्रन दिस इज द चैप्टर विच यूज टू मेक बेस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 12 ऑल्सो इन टूडेज वीडियो आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री structural representation of organic molecules like how we represent on how we represent as Lewis formula Lewis structure condensed formula and bond line formula this is all we are going to do in this chapter let's start so children introduction of organic chemistry Children, organic is a term which was used for the living creatures, for the living organisms. It was assumed in the earlier time that organic compounds are those compounds which are present in the living organisms or living beings, you would say. And these are the compounds which cannot be synthesized in a laboratory. And children, The study of all such compounds or the study of organic compounds used to be done in a branch of chemistry which is called as organic chemistry. Children, the myth of not synthesizing organic compound in laboratory was broken by a scientist known as Wohler. Wohler was the scientist who synthesized first organic compound which is known as urea and he synthesized urea with formula NH2CONH2 in chemistry lab by one inorganic compound known as ammonium cyanate I'm repeating Wohler took ammonium cyanate which was the inorganic compound he simply heat ammonium cyanate and the rearrangement of atoms happen in case of ammonium cyanate and this ammonium cyanate will turn up into urea no byproduct is formed after the heating of ammonium cyanate so urea is the first organic compound which was synthesized by Wohler in lab. Now the children, next heading, structural representation of organic molecule or organic compound. Children, in earlier classes, you have studied already how to write down the electron dot structure of covalent compound, how to write the bond structure of covalent compound. The dot structure you have studied where we used to show different electrons present in the outermost shell of the atoms which are bonded together by the sharing of electrons and we used to show all those electrons in a particular octet or in a particular duplet. All those dot structures are called electron dot structures or Lewis structures. Children, and if you remember, again I am repeating a point you have studied earlier, that the bond, the number of electrons which used to be shared in between two atoms used to be represented by dash, single dash for the sharing of one electron in between the atoms, double dash or double bond. used to represent that two electrons are sharing in between two atoms and triple dash or triple covalent bond used to represent the three electrons which are shared by two atoms children there we are calling it is bond structure here we are calling it is Lewis formula or structural formula you could say where you used to use this dash and this dash will be called as the bond the number of electrons which used to be shared in between two atoms. So let's take example. Children, see the three examples which are there on the screen: ethane, ethene, and ethyne. These three compounds we are representing here. This is the Lewis formula or the structural formula or the bond structure of any compound. By seeing such kind of dash in between the atoms, we used to understand that how many electrons are sharing in between these two carbon atoms, or this hydrogen and this carbon atom, or in this case ethyne, like how many electrons are sharing in between these two carbon atoms, how many electrons are sharing in the carbon and hydrogen, and so on. So this is called Lewis formula or the structural formula. Children, there is one more representation of the structure of organic compound, and it is called representing on bond lines. But before that, I want to tell you there is one more terminology which is known as condensed structure. In the earlier slide, you have seen the different bonds, which is called as Lewis formula or structural formula, which is giving us information what kind of bond is forming in between the different atoms. But now if you're seeing here, CH3 single bond CH3, CH2 double bond CH2, this is also called the condensed structure. Here we are only showing this carbon is bonded with single bond to another carbon atom. We are not showing elaborately how these three atoms are bonded with this carbon, or how these two hydrogen atoms are bonded with this carbon atom. This kind of representation of any organic compound is called the condensed formula. Now, the bond line formula. Children, in bond line, I want to tell you, this is the representation of a molecule symbol of carbon and hydrogen atom, where neither hydrogen or carbon will not be written in the formula. There are lines which used to represent carbon-carbon bonds, and they are drawn in a zigzag manner. And the terminals of zigzag lines represent the methyl group. Now let's understand with example. Now children, see, this is the condensed structure of a compound which is known as 3-methyl octane. Octane means there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbons in a main chain, and this is the side chain. On third carbon atom, this methyl group is present. Children, in previous slide I told you, in bond line at the end the methyl group is present. That means CH3 group on the one side and CH3 group on the other side. Children, if I show you this in this way, I am representing this 3-methyl octane. So this is carbon number 1 and this is carbon number 8, and this is the third carbon atom where the methyl group is attached. If I remove carbon and hydrogen, so I would get such kind of structure, and such kind of structure is called bond line formula. Or I am representing 3-methyl octane in a zigzag lines, and the representation of carbon and hydrogen on zigzag lines is known as I am representing compound by bond line formula. How to count now? Carbon number 1, देन इट इज कार्बन नंबर 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 एंड हियर देर आर 8 कार्बन एटम्स. नाउ द ऑन थर्ड कार्बन एटम देर इज अ मिथाइल ग्रुप. सो कार्बन नंबर 1, कार्बन नंबर 2, कार्बन नंबर 3, यू आर सीइंग ऑन थर्ड कार्बन एटम देर इज वन डैश एंड डैश मीन्स द टर्मिनल, द एंड ऑफ दिस डैश इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग इट इज मिथाइल. सो CH3 ग्रुप इज अटैच्ड ऑन दिस थर्ड कार्बन एटम एज वेल एज ऑन द बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द कंपाउंड CH3 ग्रुप इज प्रेजेंट. दिस इज हाउ वी यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट द कंपाउंड ऑन बॉन्ड लाइन और इट इज द बॉन्ड लाइन फॉर्मूला ऑफ एनी हाइड्रोकार्बन. नाउ देयर इज अ कंपाउंड 2-bromobutane. How to represent 2-bromobutane in various ways? This is the one way where this Br is actually written here in the middle of the chain, but if you see carefully, Br is actually bonded with the second carbon atom with single covalent bond. This is also a one way of representation of 2-bromobutane. This is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. This carbon number 2 is bonded with 2 carbon atoms. Third valency is fulfilled by hydrogen and fourth valency is fulfilled by bromo or bromine. So this is one way of representation. Children, again, if I want to represent this 2-bromobutane in a zigzag manner, how would I do? Say 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms, I made such kind of formula like carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4. On both the ends, methyl group is present and on second carbon, there is a bromo present. If I remove all this carbon and hydrogen, what would I get? I would get the bond line formula of 2-bromobutane, where this end and the last end is having methyl group or CH3 group, and this is carbon number 1. On second carbon atom, Br is present. This is carbon number 3 and this is carbon number 4. This is how we used to represent the compound as bond line formula. Now children, bond line formula of cyclic compounds. Cyclic compounds are those compounds which are the compound which used to form the closed loop, which used to form the ring-like structure. If you see earlier, in the earlier example, both the ends of carbon compounds were open. The methyl group was present on both the ends. They were open chain compounds. And there are some compounds which are closed chain compounds, cyclic compounds, ring-like compounds, or they used to form a closed loop, such as one example, cyclopropane. Cyclopropane, I'm calling it is cyclopropane. Cyclo means there must be one compound where no ends of a carbon will remain open. They are forming closed loop. They are forming one kind of ring. See, what is happening here? Cyclopropane. Propane means 3 carbon atoms bonded with single covalent bond. साइक्लो इज द प्रीफिक्स विच इज यूज्ड फॉर द साइक्लिक कंपाउंड्स. सो थ्री कार्बन एटम्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन अ रिंग और विच आर फॉर्मिंग अ रिंग लाइक कंपाउंड. चिल्ड्रन, इफ दिस इज द साइक्लोप्रोपेन एंड आई वॉन्ट टू रिप्रेजेंट दिस साइक्लोप्रोपेन एज बॉन्ड लाइन फॉर्मूला, वॉट वुड आई डू? I will simply remove this carbon and this hydrogen atom and I will turn up this compound in a simple triangle where the corner of the triangle will be giving me idea that carbon atom is present and by default the valency of carbon atom must be fulfilled by hydrogen atoms. Two valency of each carbon atom is fulfilled by the bonding with other two carbon atoms, and two valencies, the remaining two valencies is fulfilled by bonding with two hydrogen atoms. Let's take another example. Another example, cyclobentane. Cyclobentane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms present in a closed loop in a ring. Each carbon atom is bonded with two other carbon atom with single covalent bond, and other two electrons of carbon atoms are shared with two different hydrogen electrons forming single covalent bond. If I want to represent this cyclopentane on bond line formula, so what would I do? I will simply remove this carbon and hydrogen and I will get this pentagon where every corner of pentagon is giving me idea there is a carbon present and it is bonded with two other hydrogen atoms also. Let's take a look for the last example. Last example is where there is a compound containing six carbon atom and this is also a cyclic compound, but one carbon atom is there in the ring which is bonded with one hydrogen and one chlorine atom. So how would I represent this compound on bond line formula? Because these six carbon atoms are present at the six corner of the hexagon, I simply remove these carbon atoms plus the hydrogen atoms bonded with the carbon atoms, and on this carbon atom particularly one Cl atom is also attached. So I put one dash so that I will represent the single bond is forming in between the carbon, this particular carbon, and the chlorine atom. This is how I represent chlorocyclohexane compound on bond line formula. Children, I hope you understood how to represent compounds on bond line formula. Thank you.